So, Morgen has released a brand new AI planner-like feature, and with all of these type of applications, I am always slightly skeptical. There are loads of different ways that AI can operate in terms of scheduling, but this experience fairly impressed me, and it impressed me for two reasons. The first of those is that it's quite dynamic in terms of being able to bring in other applications that meet other criteria, and also it sort of feels a little bit like the Bento methodology. Today, I'm going to show you this AI planner and why I'm impressed with some of the features and why I think it's a good take on how artificial intelligence can organize your system in a structured manner. As you can see, I've got the desktop application open, and this new experience is called Smart Frames. And the idea behind this is quite simple in nature, because what it does, it's like a catchment of your time that correlates to a type of task or a task that is specific, that is meets a certain bunch of criteria and brings it in. And initially, it took me a little bit of time to get my head around it, but it makes total sense when you're doing it. So for example, say between 1 p.m. and 3 p.m, I have lots of energy. I also want to complete some most important tasks. So that's determined on me. That's how I work. I don't actually work that like that in real life. I just, for this example, I do. But say you work like that. Say you have a lot of energy in the morning or you have a lot of energy at night. Doesn't really matter. You can create what's called a frame. So for example, I might call this deep work as a frame, because that's where I get my intense focus. I don't have any meetings. This will help you protect from meetings by essentially putting busy, which will help to protect against meeting slots. And now here's where the frame works. So in this period of time, I can take any filter tasks from Morgen or any apps I use and have connected to Morgen. And here I'm gonna pick anything that's like large. I'm gonna pick anything that's work associated. You can add multiple ones, but in this case, I'm just gonna add only work ones here. And of course I could add to-doist if I want to with a bunch of labels or a certain type of folder or all types of tasks. And I'm gonna press schedule. Now the idea behind this is you can see, what you can see here is that it's taken the tasks that I have that are available inside of my Morgen account that meet those criteria. And what it's going to do is over in this left, right-hand side, you can really narrow it down where there's any buffers in between. And what you can do is go ahead and press schedule all. Now, because all of these meet the criteria, it's going to schedule these inside of that window. So I'm going to press schedule all, and what it's done is automatically take the tasks that meet the match and help you to do that. So here I have a task that is, as you can see, is a report, and I've added it to the certain parameters. Now what's interesting, because it also meets the smart frame parameters of this over here, this morning session, it also is going to fit into two. And the good thing is you can split longer tasks as part of that. If I press schedule, what it's going to do is help correlate all of that to the right thing that I want. If I wanted to add a midday session where my frame was related to small tasks that are in my Morgen account, maybe in my inbox, this is sort of some like wild time to get work done, then what I can do is start that. But the difference here is it won't actually schedule anything because there's nothing correlated to it. But if I have a few items that I can add as an example, then you can start to see that this time is going to plan. I can press schedule all. Now, once these smart frames are set up, what they can essentially do is start scheduling your time ahead. So for example, if you're getting incoming workload from Todoist or another application, or you are adding tasks at random, it's going to start populating your list for you based on attributes like the most important thing to get done, the due date, and other attributes like that, that you can set up as part of your AI planner. Now, there is a feature inside the settings where you can open preferences and you can choose the intensity of these. For example, you can have balance mode or hustle mode. The balance mode helps schedule your 10-minute breaks after an hour scheduled, and this schedules 20-minute breaks after 2.5 hours scheduled, which I'm currently on. You can also modify these and set things up in terms of the scheduling preferences that are best for you. Now, of course, as part of this, you can connect up more accounts. For example, there's Notion, ClickUp, Linear, Todoist, Google Tasks, and all of the other ones as well. But it's well worth a consideration if you're somebody that struggles with what to focus on next if you're part of multiple accounts. Now, the reason I most like this is twofold, is the fact that this is a scheduling type feature, which once you set and forget it and improve it to how you work every single day, it pretty much populates a task for you based on attributes that are most important. The second reason I like it is because it quite correlates to the Benta methodology, where, for example, there are small, medium, and large tasks for you to do, and your intensity and your energy is taken into account when you're working at this. So this feature is really impressed me. I like how they've integrated it. It's much more controllable than some of the AI scheduling features I've seen out there. So it's well worth consideration only if you have a lot of task consolidation needed. For example, you have 2, 3, or 4 more other apps that you use that control your time that you want to be able to weave into one location like a calendar experience. So they've done a masterful job at this. And this is one of the best ways I've seen controllable AI scheduling done right now. So that's Morgan's new Smart Frames. If you enjoyed this series, please do like it. It's a fairly new series, so comment below with what you think about it. And of course, I'll try to jump back in the comments and argue with you if you're wrong. I'd love to hear your opinion on whether this is quite useful or not for you. So thank you very much. I look forward to helping you with finding a productivity tool or software in the future. So do make sure to check out toolfinder.co if you're interested. And the link to Morgan will be below. So thanks very much. And I'll see you all very soon. Cheerio.